Hello guys, welcome to my channel Maths Pursuit. Today we are going to look into question number 1, bit 9 from exercise 1.4 of the chapter 1 called Real Numbers. So guys, let's see what we exactly have in this question. So coming to the question number 1, it is given like without actually performing the long division, state whether the following rational number will have a terminating decimal expansion or a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. And the given number is 35 by 50. Guys, we already worked out in the past with similar type of questions. So I believe we can easily do this question itself. So let's see how we can solve this question. So coming to the solution, we need to find out whether the below rational number will have a terminating decimal expansion or a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. And the given number is 35 by 50. So looking at the question, we need to just determine whether the given rational number is terminating or non-terminating repeating decimal. Because in the question it is mentioned that we are not going to do any long division calculations. For this purpose, we are more interested to know the factors of the denominator to see if it is of the form 2 to the power n and 5 to the power m. Guys, I believe you know the concept of rational number, where we always put a rational number in the form p by q, and q is not equal to 0. And in order to determine whether the given rational number is terminating or non-terminating, we need to see that q should be in the form 2 to the power n and 5 to the power m. Guys, I already made videos for this purpose. There are actually three theorems: theorem 1.5, theorem 1.6, and theorem 1.7. We need to understand these three theorems in order to judge whether the given rational number is terminating or non-terminating. If you haven't seen my video, I would request you to kindly go through my videos on these three theorems. So guys, let's move ahead. Let us now find the factor of the denominator, that is 50. Here the denominator is 50, so we are going to factorize 50. Now, dividing 50 with 2, because 2 is the least number, or I can say 2 is also a prime number, so we are getting 25. Now, we could see that 25 is divisible by the least prime number 5. So now dividing 25 with 5, I am getting 5. Now, 5 is only divisible by 5 itself. Now, after dividing 5 with 5, we are getting 1. So now our calculation of factorization stops here. And I can write 50 is equal to 2 into 5 into 5. Or I can say that is equal to 2 to the power 1 into 5 to the power 2. Or guys, I can write 35 by 50. 35 by 50 is the given number. So I can write 35 by 50 is equal to 35 by 2 to the power 1 into 5 to the power 2. Hence, guys, looking at the number, looking at the denominator, we can say that it is of the form 2 to the power n and 5 to the power m. Now we can easily say that this is a rational number and this is a terminating rational number, guys. So here our theorem helps very well to determine. So if we see any denominator with the form 2 to the power n and 5 to the power m, we can say that it is a rational number which is terminating. Hope guys you understand this calculation. If you still have any questions or concerns, kindly write to me in the comment section of my videos. I will definitely get back to you once I see your comments. If you really like my videos, kindly subscribe and let your friends know. Thank you. Bye.